And joining me now from Baku is Faris İsmailzadeh, who is the Vice Rector of Ada University, and Oktay Tanrısever, a Professor of International Relations at Middle East Technical University in Ankara. Gentlemen, welcome to Straight Talk. It's good to have you on the program. So clashes break out on a regular basis, but the latest incident was the most serious escalation since fighting in 2016, which killed hundreds on both sides. So Faris, what could you tell us about the timing and the location of these clashes?
Thank you very much for this opportunity. Indeed, we have witnessed very serious military clashes. It was provoked by Armenia. Armenian troops have attacked Azerbaijani territory. And what is interesting is that this time, attack has happened not around Nagorno-Karabakh, which is under occupation, but to the north of Nagorno-Karabakh in the area of Tovuz. And Tovuz is located near the border with Armenia, and it is a place where most of our pipelines, energy pipelines, are passing and connecting Azerbaijan to Turkey and European markets. Mm-hmm. So we believe that the provocation had two goals. One, to damage our critical energy infrastructure, and second, to somehow make Collective Security Treaty Organization, which Armenia is a member of, to intervene and to support Armenia. So this is the first time that the serious clashes have taken place near Tovuz, although sporadic fighting takes place on a regular basis.
So this latest incident exposed the vulnerability of these energy infrastructure. Oktay, in your opinion, what should be done in the future?
I think it is very important for international community, and especially the countries that benefit from Nabucco, Baku Tbilisi, Ceyhan, as well as international oil companies, to give sound warning to Armenian leadership that these energy networks and transportation corridor should be kept free from such attacks, and international community is sensitive to such aggression. Armenian aggression should be stopped because of international interest involved in this region. Azerbaijan is very important internationally.
Yes.
It is very important European energy security. So Armenian side should take this into account.
Besides their deep-seated historic and social relations, Ankara and Baku have recently engaged in multi-billion dollar energy projects. So what's at stake for Turkey when it comes to the stability of the Caucasus, and what's at stake for the Western community, which wants to reduce its dependence on Russia?
Yes, as you know, Azerbaijan and Turkey are very strong allies. We are strategic partners, and we have been developing many regional energy infrastructure projects that are of mutual benefit both to Azerbaijan and to Turkey, as well as our European partners. Very soon we are planning to open a new pipeline, gas pipeline, which will bring Azerbaijani gas to Italian markets and European markets. So I think Turkey and Azerbaijan are mutually supporting each other. They are supporting each other not only in economic fields but also in political, military fields. Thanks to Turkish support, we are modernizing our army, and Azerbaijani army is now much stronger than in 1990s, and we are able to repel the attacks of aggressors. So this alliance, this partnership is very beneficial for the peace, stability, and development in the Caucasus region.
Yeah, so Oktay, how could Turkey help Azerbaijan amid escalating tensions? I mean, to what extent it could help Baku? Can it, let's say, intervene militarily?
I think Turkey's main contribution to Azerbaijani security, as well as regional security in the Caucasus, lies in its deterrent capacity. Turkey has been quite active throughout the recent crisis, and I think its demonstration of force sent a clear message that any aggression will not be tolerated. Mm-hmm. And recent military exercises also gave the clear, give another message that Turkey supports Azerbaijani security strongly.
Yes.
But in the run, Turkey's security cooperation with Azerbaijan will get stronger.
So, Faris, how do you think this joint military exercises carried out by Turkey and Azerbaijan reflect on the Turkey-Russia rift? And aftermath the clashes, Turkish President Recep Tayyip Erdoğan condemning the Armenian aggression said Yerevan was out of its depth. What do you think he meant, and did he imply another actor?
Yes, we are very much appreciating the support by President Erdoğan. He has clearly expressed support to Azerbaijan, territorial integrity of Azerbaijan, and Turkish Foreign Ministry have condemned the attacks by Armenians, so we very much appreciate that. Many other countries, including Islamic countries, have supported us and they have condemned attacks. Turkey and Azerbaijan have planned military exercises long ago. This is part of our strategic partnership. It takes place every year. It is not geared against any country. It is not geared against any neighbor. We are trying to help each other to modernize our armies, exchange experience. And these military exercises have been planned long ago, but they have been very helpful to us because it really reinforces strong Turkish interest in the Caucasus region. It shows that Turkey is behind Azerbaijan, that Turkey cares about Azerbaijan's development, energy infrastructure, territorial integrity. So we very much appreciate that, and we hope that this mutual support will be continued in the future as well. I think that Russia has nothing to worry about because this is purely for modernizing capabilities of both countries.
So, Oktay, how ironic it is for Russia for being one of the chairs of the Minsk group and at the same time procurers of military equipment to both Armenia and Azerbaijan.
As you rightly mentioned, this policy is not only unique for Nagorno-Karabakh. Russia has been doing this for Georgia, for Moldova, in these frozen conflicts. It presents its military role in these countries as a peacekeeping force or force of stability. But as you rightly mentioned, Moscow benefits from its role and presence to put more pressure on regional countries. It's not only putting pressure on Azerbaijan, but also for Armenia. Armenia doesn't seem to be a fully independent country. It seems to be under strict military control of Russia. So Nagorno-Karabakh conflict enables Moscow to maintain its military control in the region.
Oh, so Faris, what kind of implications this latest flare-up will have on Iran's domestic arena, because Azerbaijanis in Iran call for protests and demonstrations against Tehran's support. You just mentioned how the Islamic countries condemned the latest clashes, but isn't it how ironic for Iran, which portrays itself as an Islamic country, but chooses to side with Armenia when the issue comes with this conflict?
It is true. Many people in Azerbaijan are quite concerned about the high level of cooperation that takes place between Iran and Armenia. Iran openly trades with Armenia, and we are quite concerned because many regions that are under occupation have many destroyed mosques and many cultural heritage of Islam, Islamic cultural heritage objects are destroyed as well. So I think that Iran should reconsider its policy and try to support more Azerbaijan's territorial integrity, liberation of the occupied territories. That's generally the policy and the vision of official Baku, and people in Azerbaijan believe that way. I believe that more and more we will see young Azerbaijanis, ethnic Azerbaijanis living in Iran, putting pressure on government to support Azerbaijan through social media, through different technological channels. I think more young people are aware about occupation, about refugees, about the aggression, and therefore they will put more pressure on Iranian government to stop cooperation with Armenia.
So, Oktay, is a peaceful resolution to this conflict possible given the latest developments?
I'm not sure, but it is necessary. I think we should, international community should put more pressure. I have one suggestion in that respect. OSCE Minsk co-chairs are not really effective. Turkey should be included in that process as part of the co-chair process. In that way, Azerbaijani concerns would be raised, and there would be more pressure on Armenia to come to the table and reach a sustainable solution. Otherwise, current status quo benefits Yerevan and Moscow. They don't see any reason why sustainable solution should be solved. So I think international community should take this clashes very seriously and give more room to diplomacy.
Yes.
And Turkey could play a very positive role in that process.
All right, gentlemen, unfortunately, we're out of time. Thank you for joining us on Straight Talk. Appreciate it a lot.